Bell News, taking Ghana to the next level.
The sector minister, honorable lawyer Joe Gatti.
Abrafo Okwan was just 947 kilometers of railway line. A core Oshasi fi second D, Osiba Kumasi, Oshasi 1898, 1903, na Wazidu Kumasi. And if you wash a Kosasi from Accra, Osiba Kumasi. Also Oshasi 1910, Wazidu Kumasi 1923. It's actually Ghana Gold Coast Abakasama. The last time a railway line for Furoba Ashanti region and Kumasi or in 1923. So from 1923 to 2020, under President Nana Akufo-Addo, railway has come to Kumasi again. In that Meijine, it is from Edum to Kasi as the first phase. The same contractors bear from Kasi to Ediabin, and the same contractors will do from Ediabin to Ejusu. Now, from Edum to Kasi, on Yayen Sunku, because it is going to be a double line. Lines, yeah, well, God, this is a single line. The length of the route is 6 kilometers. This is the first standard gauge double line that is being constructed in Ghana. Since the president came to power, every line that we have developed is a standard gauge line. And today is a historic day, not only because that it is the first time we are bringing standard gauge into Kumasi, but it's also the fact that for the first time in the history of this country, a Ghanaian company is going to be the lead company to develop a railway network. Within 4 years, a lot of work has been done. But it's not only construction that has been done. Our new network of over 3,500 kilometers, almost 2/3 of that network, as I speak with you, we have feasibility studies and we also have preliminary engineering designs. The 640 kilometer proposed line from Kumasi to Paga, we shall be having our final stakeholder consultation. And after that, we are ready to go to town and look for strategic investors to invest in the line, or to advise government that government has to put its money on. That line will go from Ediadi towards Bechem to Siain, Techiman, Tamale, and then to Paga. The sector recognizes that the viability of the Bankra Inland Port depends to a large extent on the development of a railway line. We are at the last stages, as I hope that sooner than we all expect, we'll be cutting the sword to commence the development of the line from Accra towards Kumasi. Ashanti is the center of the railway industry. Train Ofi North, Ababa Ashanti. Train Ofi Takoradi, Ababa Ashanti. Train Ofi Accra, Ababa Ashanti. So Ashanti is the future of the development of a new modern standard gauge network under President Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo. So Mr. Rawat, railway sector nzi. Se if you be an SN2 man and I go for a row. If your railway, I could see ya. A binum wire 15.6 kilometers. Nana Kufo-Addo within 3 years, Oku do 200 kilometers in Fiona Pet, Natuma, Nana Kufo-Addo.
Oh, be sorry. Yen find a day, yen find some work, yen find shy a map, and I
I have said on several occasions that one of the tragedies of our post-colonial development was allowing our railway infrastructure to deteriorate completely. By January 2017, out of the 947 kilometers of colonial narrow-gauge railway network bequeathed to us by the colonialists, barely 10% was operational. Indeed, apart from the 15-kilometer narrow-gauge railway line, built between 2012 and 2017 from Sekondi to Takoradi via Kojokrom, no kilometer of railway line had been added. Upon my assumption of office, I was determined to change the statistic because I believe that the presence of an efficient, well-connected railway system was critical, is critical to the progress, prosperity, and development of our nation. This led me to the decision to establish Ministry of Railway Development with the dynamic Honorable Jogate, Member of Parliament for Sikadu Katang, that is the Member of Parliament from Railway Country, at the helm of affairs. By all accounts, this has started yielding fruits. Today's event, the cutting of the soil for the construction of the 83.5-kilometer Kumasi to Obuasi line, is a clear manifestation of the Akufo-Addo government's policy to grow and develop the country's railway sector. Now, madam, ladies and gentlemen, earlier this year, Cabinet and then Parliament both approved a 500 million euro agreement for the construction of a new standard gauge line from Takoradi Harbour to Kojokrom and also from Mansur to Huni Valley. Once completed, 102 kilometers of new standard gauge railway lines would have been constructed as part of the development of a new standard gauge western line. Indeed, the Kumasi to Obuasi section for which I'm cutting the soil today is part of the new western line. This line is critical for the successful establishment of the new bauxite and aluminum industry being promoted by government. The Sheni and Upon Mansur iron ore deposits exploitation, which will form the basis of the imminent iron and steel industry, requires a modern railway network to transport the ore and the processed raw material. I'm happy to hear the commitment of the contractor, David Walter, to completing the works on schedule and on budget. This is the kind of reassurance we need from every responsible contractor. In the first 4 years of my administration, more construction activity in the railway sector has gone on than in any period since independence. Over the last 3 years and 10 months, we've laid a solid foundation for railway development, which will receive an even greater input when Nana and the MPP get 4 more years to do more for you.
Rail News, taking Ghana to the next level.